Shalom, giving all praise to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai Bahasham, Rechah HaKodesh. Double honors to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone who rule well. And as always, we give peace and salutations unto the elect, starting with the Tabernacle of David, the 144,000 priests chosen from the foundation of the earth, all right, who have the new song and who are preaching it in these latter days. Also, to the large multitude, the rest of the men, women, and children whom the Lord will have mercy on of the nation of Israel. All right, this body is known as the remnant. And we talk about the remnant a lot because the scriptures speak about the remnant a lot. And it even gives a step-by-step understanding on how, you know, through the preaching of the word, that they would raise up in the latter days. The Heavenly Father would put his spirit, return his spirit unto them after they had been cast off, all right, into a major captivity, Babylon the Great, and various other captivities all around the planet Earth, man, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. Because when you look at the narrative of the Bible, which Christians don't deal with, the Israelites would be scattered. Okay, so today we're going to deal with the remnant, and then we're going to go into the scriptures and show you the remnant, all right, in Revelation the 7th chapter, and prove to you that these are all Israelites. Okay, here it is. You have now Christians speaking of this multi nationality church, which at the end of the day, Israelites will come from multi nations, from multi tongues, and are going to be gathered back to the Heavenly Father through his son Yahweh Shai, man. And that's what's getting ready to happen on the planet Earth. All right, now I'm going to start here. This is a very this is one of the scriptures we use a lot. Okay, this is Isaiah, the 10th chapter and the 20th verse. It says, "It shall come to pass in that day that the remnant of Israel and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob." All right, now you always see this narrative of Israel and Jacob, or Israel and Judah, or Judah and Jerusalem. What is this speaking of? This is speaking of all 12 tribes being brought back together. All right, because the last time that happened was under King David. All right, and then Solomon sat on his throne. Okay, and all 12 tribes acknowledged, you know, David as king. All right, and then after David passed away, the throne, all right, was assumed by his son Solomon. Okay, who would sit on his throne, and he had 40 years of peace. Okay, all 12 tribes were together. All right, after Solomon's death, and even before Israel started to wax away, okay, and all 12 tribes eventually split. The kingdom was split, okay, and Judah was under the dominion of Rehoboam, Solomon's direct son, okay, by an Ammonite queen, showing you that the father holds the seed. No matter what earth he plants his seed in, what comes out is going to be what the father is. Okay, and then you had the northern kingdom led by Jeroboam, okay, which was one of Solomon's hitmen. And from that point, the kingdom was rent, and all 12 tribes since that point have been scattered, you know, into different captivities up until this day, and we haven't been together as one. Okay, so when you hear about the throne of David, the throne of David is speaking of all 12 tribes, okay, dwelling in unity together, you see? So that's what Yahweh Shai is coming to do, gather all 12 tribes back together, you see? And he's doing it starting with this word going out. So I just wanted to break that down as well, because this is the narrative that Christians and people, when dealing with the scriptures, love to just throw away. Solomon's kingdom, that 40 years of peace, was symbolic of the kingdom of heaven. And it wasn't a multi nation kingdom. All right, although we did deal fairly with the heathen after they were subdued, okay, the kingdom was to the Israelites, and Solomon sat on the throne of David. So let's go back here to Isaiah, the 10th chapter and the 20th verse. "And there has not been any Israelite state or government, and there's none promised to come until the Messiah comes on the scene." When the Messiah comes and gathers the Israelites from the four corners of the earth, which we'll show you, okay, As a matter of fact, let's get that. Start there in the book of let's see here. Matthew, the 24th chapter. I'll just go to it. Matthew 24. Because he's going to gather the remnant when he returns. Okay, Matthew 24 and 31. All right, Matthew 24 and 31. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds and from one end of heaven to another. Okay, so this is what we're going to deal with. Who is this elect? All right, we'll go back to that as well. Who is this elect? Okay, so going back here, this is Isaiah 10 and 20. And it shall come to pass that the remnant of Israel and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob shall no more again stay upon him that smote them, but they shall stay upon the Lord Yahweh, the Holy One of Israel in truth. The remnant shall return, even the remnant of Jacob. See, that's the elect, the remnant of Jacob, unto the Almighty God. For though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, you see that? Yet a remnant of them shall return, and the consumption decree shall overflow of righteousness. Now, why is this? It's very important to understand history, because who was promised that their seed would be as the sand of the sea? Abraham. Let's get that. Let's move that up. This is Genesis 15 and 5. And he brought him forth abroad and said, look now towards the heaven and tell the stars if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. So Israel was promised to be as the sand of the sea. Now, right here, he was speaking to Abraham, but eventually Abraham had Isaac, and then Isaac had Jacob, okay? And when you even look it up, the stars of heaven, okay, that was told to Abraham, okay? And then again here, Genesis 22 and 17, that in blessing I will bless thee, in multiplying I will multiply thee, thy seed as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore. Okay? Right? That's on the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. You see? Genesis 26 and 4. I will make thy seed to multiply as the stars of heaven, and I will give thy seed all these countries, and in thy seed shall all the nations on the earth be blessed, because Israel will be scattered amongst all of these nations, man. Okay, Exodus 32 and 13. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants, to whom thou swearest of thine own self, and saidest unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have spoken of will I give unto your seed, and they shall inherit it forever. So we, as the Israelites, are as the stars of heaven. But what does it say? Only a remnant would return. Okay, so this is Isaiah 10 and 22. For though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, it's the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. All right, we're the sand of the sea. We're large in number as a nation. All right, meaning a lot of people you see are Israelites. But guess what? A remnant shall return. Let's look up the word for remnant. Salakia. I don't know what happened. We're going to get that in a minute. Let's see here. Remnant. Okay, let's get this in the book of Isaiah. Yeah, this is a good one too. Isaiah 11 and 11, it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again a second time, okay, to recover his people, because the great deliverance will be from Babylon the Great. The first great deliverance was from out of the land of Egypt. Okay? And who was there to deliver us? The angel of the Heavenly Father, which is Yahawashi. See, it was the power of the Most High, but how did he do it? Through his angel, which he told us we were to obey. Now, let me turn the phone this way, see if I can get it. Interesting. Won't come up. Let's see if we can do it this way. Isaiah. Okay. Isaiah 11 and 11. We're just trying to look up the word remnant. Okay. Let's see here. Lord willing, it comes up. Must be an issue because I'm out here in the woods. Let's see if we can do it here. Salakia. App, everything was good before I started. But now it's, you know how it goes. Isaiah 11 and 11. The remnant, that's the word we're looking for. Shaar. All right. Rest, residue, remnant, remainder. Okay. Shaar, to remain, to be left over, and it also means kindred, kinfolk, kindred. Your and this is the kinfolk. This is the remnant. You know that the Heavenly Father is going to deliver out of that large multitude. See, Abraham was promised that his seed would be as the stars of heaven through Isaac and Jacob. They were promised the same thing, but it would only be a remnant who will return to be heirs to that promise to get that land. Okay? So let's also get the book of Joel, the second chapter, because there's various scriptures that deal with the remnant. Let's see here. The book of Joel 2. Okay, this is the book of Joel 2. Let's see here. And 32. It says, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call upon the name of Yahweh shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem, see that? Mount Zion and in Jerusalem. All right, and Mount Zion, which also is called Sion, we'll get that understanding, represents the city of David, basically, man. The Lord's monument. Okay, and he's remembered us in these latter days, and the prophecies are being fulfilled. He remembered us by what? Returning his spirit unto us. Because Israel had been cast off year after year after year, but the promise was always that he would not cast us off forever and bring a remnant back through the spirit, okay, so that everything can be restored, man. Okay, now it says, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of Yahweh shall be delivered, for in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be a deliverance, as the Lord hath said, and in the remnant whom the Yahweh shall call. So it's about the remnant, man. Okay, it's all about that remnant, man. And we're fulfilling that prophecy, man. And the Lord have called us. We didn't call him. He called us and gave us the spirit to call upon him, man. But there's various scriptures I had up, you know, here in this app. It's acting a damn fool. We're remnant. That you can look these scriptures up, and it gives you, I mean, in the book of Ezekiel, there's so many, you know, even in Isaiah, I'll turn it this way. Even in the book of Isaiah, there's a lot of the scriptures talking about the remnant, man. So we're going to go and show you in the book of Revelation, the seventh chapter, who that remnant is. Okay? There's an order to that remnant. Okay? Let's see here. Let's get one more and then we'll jump. Let's see here. Ezekiel 14:22, yet behold, therein shall be left a remnant that shall be brought forth, both sons and daughters. Behold, they shall come forth unto you, and ye shall see their way and their doings, and ye shall be comforted concerning the evil that I have brought upon Jerusalem, and concerning all that I have brought upon it. Okay? So it's various scriptures that deal with the remnant of Jacob, man. Micah 2:12, I will surely assemble, O Jacob, all of thee. I will surely gather the remnant. See? So there's various scriptures that speak on the remnant of Jacob, the remnant of Israel, man. Okay? So now, when you go to that order, first let's go to the book of, see if we can get the book of, was it 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter? 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. We'll start at around 22. Okay? Let's see here. First Corinthians 15:22, for as in Adam all die, even so in Hamashiach Yahawashi shall all be made alive. All right? Because we were all supposed to, you know, the sons of God were supposed to be all in order under Adam, but guess what happened? Eve and Adam's sin, which caused us to fall. We all fell under that order. But under Yahawashi, we're all gonna be brought back. So the mistake he made as Adam, the mistake he made as Solomon, or he got it right when he came on the scene as Yahawashi. Okay, so if you look at our nation, the throughness started with Adam. You know, he's the Alpha, he's the beginning of throughness. All right, and then Solomon. All of our miseries as a nation started with the fall of Adam, all right, and then Solomon, man. Because after Solomon's fall, the kingdom was rent. And we were scattered. You had the northern kingdom go into the Assyrian captivity. And then you had the southern kingdom go into the Babylonian captivity. And from there, we've been from captivity to captivity, man. We haven't been together as one nation since. So when will we be together as one nation? It starts now with this word going out through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashim Yahawashi. And they're pissed off to see this, man. Okay? This is the day that they never thought would come. Okay, just give me 1 second. All right, give me 1 second. All right, 1 Corinthians 15:21. For since by man came death, all right, by man came also the resurrection of the dead, which is Yahawashi. He conquered death. Okay, so he got it right when he came as Yahawashi. And if you notice, what was the thing he didn't have that time? A woman. All right, because as Adam, it was Eve who caused him to sin. As Solomon, it was the women who caused him to sin. So this time he came as Yahawashi, and he got the job done. Okay, and now he's on the right-hand side making intercession for us, man. Okay, so it says, for as in Adam all die, all right, so in Hamashiach shall all be made alive. And that's happening now. All of the remnant who we have called. Here we go. But every man in his own order. Hamashiach, the first fruits. Afterward, they that are Hamashiachs at his coming. And that's what we're going to deal with real quick. Okay. The Hamashiach, Yahawashi, and the first fruits, which is the church. The head of the church. Which is Yahawashi and the 144,000, man. Okay, and after that, you're going to have those who are Yahawashi at his coming, all right, which are the large multitude, and we're going to read about this in the book of Revelation, the 7th chapter. Give me 1 second. All right, Revelation, the 7th chapter, and I'll just start at 4. Well, as a matter of fact, I'll just start at 1 and I'll read down. But this is very important, man, because Christians, they try to hijack these scriptures and they don't see, when you don't deal with prophecy and you don't deal with the narrative of the Bible, you can go around just butchering, man. And that's what they do. you have to set, you can't just start the book and just go straight to Revelation 7 without explaining, you know, Israel would be scattered, you know, amongst all of these nations, man, as a punishment, but the Lord would have mercy and gather them, a remnant of them, out of these countries where they were scattered, man. You can't leave that narrative off and just jump to the book of Matthew, the book of Revelation, and all of these things, man. Now let's go ahead and read this. This is the book of Revelation 7 and 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw an angel ascending from the east, having the seal of God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of God in their foreheads. Okay, and that's what's happening right now on the earth. The elect is being sealed. That's why we're getting closer to the destruction. The destruction is not going to come until all of the elect who the Lord want are sealed, man, with this understanding, so they can call back on him wherever they may be. Okay, and this is what's happening on the earth. This is why they're trying to stop the progress of this word, and they're in a rush to set up their new world order, because as we wake up, the end comes, man. Okay? It says, and I heard the number of them which were sealed, all right? And there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of Israel. All right, now in times past, vocab and a lot of Christians, would make the narrative, the narrative was, yeah, these are Israelites, all right, but then when you go down, it speaks of a large multitude. Those are the heathen from all of the other nations. So we'll show you that that's a damn lie. But now the new thing, which they believed all along, is that this is not, this has nothing to do with the physical seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who were promised to receive that land, to be heirs to that promise. This is speaking of all multinational, all right, church. And we're going to explain that, because in a sense, it is going to be Israelites. It is going to be particular Israelites from all nations of the earth. All right. Because this is the remnant being gathered back from out of all of these countries where they were scattered. Okay. But it starts with the 144,000, right? You have Judah, Asher, Simeon, Zebulun, all right, and so forth. When you go up, it gives you the 12,000 out of each tribe. Now, this is the first fruits, okay? The first. Give me 1 second here. Revelation 7. And now we'll go to verse 9, because after it breaks down, okay, this 144,000, it goes to what? Verse 9, and after this, I beheld, and lo, now this is John the Revelator seeing this. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, all right, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds. Now let's look up this word kindreds. I don't know if it'll do it since I put it on airplane mode, so I'll go here. The book of Revelation, the 7th chapter. All right. Revelation 7. And 9, and after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number. This is after the 144,000. So this body is the remnant. As we always, before we open up, we say peace and salutations to the elect, starting with the house of David. The tabernacle of David is the 144,000. Okay, the Lord said the tabernacle was with men, but after that you have a large multitude, because what did he say? He said it would be sons and daughters. Okay, so the large multitude, which will mainly be of women, we believe, are the rest of the men, women, and children whom the Lord are going to have mercy on. and they're going to be gathered as well. Okay? A large multitude which no man can number of all nations and kindreds. Now let's look up this word kindred. Phula. Okay? A tribe in the New Testament, all persons descending from one of the 12 sons of the patriarch of Jacob. This is the kindred that have been scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. We're all still related. We all still have a common ancestor, and that goes back to Abraham, okay, Isaac and Jacob. And even before that, it goes back all the way to Adam. Okay, this is what the Bible is dealing with. Okay, that seed, okay, in this chapter is showing you the gatherings. Because what did it say? Yahweh Shai will gather his elect from the four corners of the earth. Now this is that. The 144,000, okay, which, you know, some of these men will already be on the chariot, but they're going to come in their order. The 144,000, and then the large multitude. They are, that are Hamashiach that is coming. This is the remnant whom the Lord is going to gather, who he promised he would gather. So it says, in the New Testament, all persons descending from one of the 12 sons of the patriarch Jacob. Which, what did the Lord tell Jacob? Let's get that in the book of Genesis. So Genesis, the 35th chapter. Okay, Genesis, the 35th chapter. There we go. Genesis 35. And we'll start at the 10th verse. And God said unto him, thy name is Jacob. Thy name shall not be called any more Jacob, but Israel shall be thy name. And he called his name Israel. And God said unto him, I am the God Almighty. Be fruitful and multiply. A nation, all right, and a company of nations shall be of thee. And kings shall come out of thy loins. So the nation and the company of nations are the ones who will be out of the 12 sons of Jacob. Kings will be out of thy loins. And the land which I gave unto thee, to Abraham and Isaac, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed after thee will I give the land. Now, what are all 12 tribes being gathered back to the Heavenly Father for? So we can rule out of that land that he promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But right here it says the promises to Abraham, Isaac, and to Jacob, and his seed after him. So the seed would be as the sand of the sea, but we're reading about the remnant that the Heavenly Father is going to bring back to be heirs to receive that promise. You see, right here, we're showing you that, man. So even going back to where we were in Revelation 7, okay, so this large multitude, after the 144,000 are numbered, okay, after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, and we're going to show you that these are all Israelites too, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands. And palms represents victory. Okay, when warriors return home from war after they won a war, okay, one of the main things that will be waved is what? Palms, man. Palms are representative and symbolic of victory. We have the victory. The victory is going to be given to the remnant, the elect, under Yahweh Shai, the 144. And then you have the rest, all right, which, man, we have a great chance to be a part of this number. Now, let's also get the book of Ezekiel, okay, because we deal with the volume of the book, you see. Hey, Yahweh Shai himself told those scribes and Pharisees, scriptures can't be broken. But here it is, a Christian comes, and all of a sudden, all of these promises that we're reading about in the history and the prophecy, none of that matters. And now there's a multinational church, multi-nation, meaning all physical heathen are now in covenant with the Heavenly Father, man, and his son, through his son. That's a damn lie. The covenants were only given unto Israel, man. Now, Ezekiel 36. And we'll start at 17. This is a lot of history that we have to know, man. And prophecy. Ezekiel 36 and 17. Son of man, when the house of Israel dwelt in their own land, Jerusalem, they defiled it by their own way and by their doings. Their way was before me as the uncleanliness of a removed woman, because we committed adultery against the Lord. Wherefore I poured my fury upon them for the blood that they had shed upon the land, and for the idols wherewith they had polluted it. And I scattered them among the heathen, whether they were dispersed throughout the countries according to the way of their doings, I judged them. You see that? And what's happening is now we're praising the Lord among the Gentiles, as the prophecy said we would do. This is that work. All right. The Lord said, I will work a work in your day that even though I tell it to you, you won't believe it. This is that work that the Lord have scattered us throughout all of these countries. And now merely just through the preaching of the word, he's gathering us back. And it started back there with those Gentiles who received the Holy Spirit. But now we're those Gentiles, man, who are going to be heirs to that promise, man, gathered out of these different countries. One second. See? So I scattered them among the heathen, and they were dispersed throughout all the countries according to their way and according to their doings. I judged them. We were judged. And when they were entered unto the heathen, whither they went, they profaned my holy name. When they said unto them, these are the people of the Lord that are going forth out of this land. So they're like, this is the Lord's people? And then when you look at what they were doing, you'd be like, ugh. Because we were supposed to be the standard of all nations to show them how to live, going all the way back to Adam. We were the ones given the ways, all right, of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, man, to turn this earth to paradise, to show these heathen how to live. But sin and rebellion led to the heathen ruling over us, man. So it says, these are the people of the Lord that have gone forth out of this land. We were scattered. But I had pity for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the heathen, whether they went. Okay. Therefore, say unto the house of Israel, thus saith the Lord God, I do not this for your sakes, O house of Israel, but for my holy name's sake, which ye have profaned among the heathen, whether ye went. And I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen. That's another thing, narrative that you have to pay close attention to, among the heathen, among the Gentiles. Because the Israelites were scattered among them, but were returned to him, a remnant of them. Okay? And the heathen shall know that I am the Lord, Yahweh, saith the Lord God, when I shall be sanctified in you before their eyes. And they're damn sure seeing it now, and they're afraid. Because the Heavenly Father has returned his spirit unto us, as he have promised, and the heathen are like, hell no. Nah. The heathen they're afraid, they don't know what to do. Especially Karen. Why you think Karen is acting like she's acting? She's acting that way because ultimately in the earth there's a spirit. And these Edomites and these heathen know, damn. We had them down. We, you know, the drugs, the rap music, all everything we did to them, and we tried to keep the name of Israel out of the earth, but it didn't work because of that remnant and that promise, man. For I will take you from among the heathen and gather you out of all countries and bring you into your own land. All 12 tribes. Is not that what's promised? Ezekiel 37. Okay. As a matter of fact. In 21. And say unto them, to who? The Israelites. This is what the prophets are telling the Israelites with the 12 tribe sign. It's all in this chapter. The dry bones awakening, man. Thus saith the Lord, and say unto them, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whether they be gone, and I will gather them on every side. This is the remnant, and bring them into their own land, and I will make them one nation. You see? And when you read up, it's dealing with Verse 19, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is in the hand of Ephraim, and the tribes of Israel, his fellows, and I will put them with him, even the stick of Judah, and make them one stick, and they shall be one in my hand. This is the throne of David, because under David, all 12 tribes acknowledged him as king, and he had a throne. He got the Ark of the Covenant, brought it to Jerusalem. He set up shop. He subdued all of the heathen. And then Solomon had 40 years of peace, but we were rent from that point. But the Lord is saying, I'm going to bring you all back together through this remnant. So this whole thing is about Israel, man. Okay? But he's going to take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whether they be gone, and gather them on every side and bring them into their land, and shall make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king over them all, and they shall be no more two nations. Neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms anymore at all, because the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is still here, and they're as the sand of the sea. You see, in the remnant that the Lord will call has awakened. Call halal Yahweh Bashmiyah Shah. Then it says, neither shall they defile themselves any more with their idols, nor their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places, wherein they have sinned, and cleanse them, so shall they be my people, and I will be their God. Because he's going to put the laws in us. It was sin that separated us from our power. Okay, and when you just jump to verse 25, and they shall dwell in the land that I have given unto Jacob my servant, wherein your fathers have dwelt, and they shall dwell therein, even they and their children and their children's children forever, and my servant David shall be their prince forever, man. Okay? Moreover, I will make a covenant of peace with them, and it shall be an everlasting covenant, and I will place them and multiply them and set my sanctuary in the midst of them evermore. My tabernacle shall also be with them, yea, I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And that's the priesthood, because the tabernacle of the Most High, when you read Revelation, the 21st chapter, is going to be with men. And the temple, all right, which was, you know, basically Mount Zion, Jerusalem, you know, represented the direct dwelling of the Most High on the earth. So he's going to dwell with us through Yahweh Shai and 144, and all Israel will be perfect, man. Okay, but when you read here, verse 3, Revelation 21:3, and I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them. Okay, so the sacrifice of the first fruits, man, is very, very important, man. And the first fruits are the 144,000. So with knowing that, let's go back to Revelation, the 7th chapter, and read that again, because we know now that Israel will be gathered. Let's get one more. Jeremiah 16. Okay. Jeremiah 16. Jeremiah 16. And Fortune, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that will no more be, there shall no more be said that the Lord liveth that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt, but the Lord liveth that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north, Babylon the great, this modern day Egypt, and from all the lands whither he have driven them, and I will bring them again into their own land that I have given unto their fathers. Who was their fathers? Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So that's, you know, this is what Revelation, the 7th chapter, is speaking of. After the 144,000 are named, verse 9 says, and after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations, and kindreds, and people, and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes in their hands. And we're going to show you and prove to you that these are all Israelites. We just proved it, but we're going to go even further, man. And cry with a loud voice, salvation unto our God. What God is this? The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, man. That's why it says in Luke, the 1st chapter, blessed be the Lord God of Israel. Okay? And they're crying with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne, and unto the Lamb who gathered them. This is the remnant, the 144 and the large multitude. Okay? All right. We're struggling through it, but we're going to get through it, Lord willing. Hopefully, y'all are being edified. And it says, and the angels stood round about the throne, and the elders and the four beasts fell before the throne of their faces and worshiped God. All right. Saying, Amon, blessed in glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amon. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, what are these which are arrayed in white robes, and whence came they? He's speaking about this large multitude. Who are they? You see? And he said unto them, sir, thou knowest. So John is like, you know, I don't know. I'm being showed this vision. These are they which came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God, all right, which is ultimately the 144,000, okay, under Yahawashi, okay, the throne of David, and shall serve him day and night in his temple, and he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. And they shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. And that's not saying the sun is going to be gone, but we're going to have that light, that wisdom will be within us, the law, statutes, and commandments, man. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them and shall lead them to living fountains of waters, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, because he's going to give us the day star, man. Okay? So now, let's go to the book of 2nd Esdras. Salakia. 2nd Esdras, the second chapter, and end it. Okay? 2nd Esdras, the seventh chapter. Second chapter. All right? And let's, 34 is good. And therefore I say unto you, O ye heathen that hear and understand, look for your shepherd, and he shall give you everlasting rest, for he is nigh at hand that shall come in the end of the world. Now this heathen is speaking of us, because we were in a heathen-like state, all right? But we're being gathered and transformed. Ye were Gentiles, and the proof that these heathen is speaking of Israelites, when you go up to like verse 28, it says, the heathen shall envy thee, but they shall not be able to do anything against thee. So this is the Israelites scattered among the heathen. Okay? These are the heathen that Paul went to and start preaching the word, man. Because of their doings, they were heathen. Okay? These aren't natural heathen. Israelites scattered among the heathen became heathen through their works. Okay? Now, let's see here. I start at 40. Okay? Because this is the same thing that John the Revelator saw. Now Esdras is seeing it. It says, take thy number, O Sion. Okay? Now what is Sion? Okay? I'm going to read this out of this book. Because also in the Greek is Sion, which is known as the parched place, but it really is to Zion, the monument of the Lord. And I'll read this out of the Bible dictionary. It says, Sion, Hebrew to Zion, Greek Sion, meaning of the word uncertain. We know to Zion means monument. They say Sion means parched place, but either way it go, it says, one of the hills on which Jerusalem stood. Okay, it is first mentioned in the Old Testament as the Jebusites' fortress, and we know David went and got that. Okay, 1 Samuel 5:6-9. David captured it and called it the city of David. The city of David, man. Now, here it is. The Lord said he's going to build the tabernacle of David, as in the days of old. Where were the heathen at when David had his tabernacle? They were subdued. Okay? It says we're going to sing the song of Moses. Okay, Where were the heathen at? Were they joined with Israel at those times? Hell no. Okay? It says, and captured it and called it the city of David, man. All right? And you can read more on that. So basically, this is Jerusalem, man. Okay? Where the temple dwelled. Okay? Near Mount Moriah and all of that. Okay? Where Solomon was going to be sacrificed by Abraham. Where Isaac was going to be sacrificed by Abraham. Selachia. And where Solomon built the temple. So this is speaking of Israel, man. Mount Zion. As a matter of fact, when you go to Revelation, the 14th chapter, what does it say? Revelation 14 and 1. And lo, I looked, and lo, a lamb stood upon the Mount Zion, and with them 144,000, having his father's name written in their foreheads, man. Okay, this is the government. Because what did it say? The law shall go forth of Jerusalem. This is speaking of the governing body, man, and the order of it. Okay? This word for Zion, let's just look it up here for truth's sake. Zion. Zion or Zion, a parched place, the hill on which the higher and more ancient part of Jerusalem was built. Okay? A southwesternmost highest of the hills on which the city was built, often used for the entire city of Jerusalem, since Jerusalem, because the temple stood there, was called the dwelling place of God. So these are Israelites. These are Israelites that we're reading about here. Okay? Take thy number, 2nd Edges 2 and 40. Take thy number, O Zion, Zion, the monument of the Lord, Jerusalem, the holy city. Okay? And shut up those of thine that are clothed in white. And this is the remnant, man, which have fulfilled the law of the Lord. The number of thy children whom thou longest for is fulfilled. Beseech the power of the Lord, that thy people, which have been called from the beginning, may be hallowed. Okay? Not all nations, the people which were called from the beginning, which were the Israelites. Okay? Starting with Adam, the sons of God. All right? Who fell. And then there's a narrative in the Bible of how they would eventually, you know, become a great nation. Okay? In Egypt. All right, and many other things, man. They received the laws, okay? They broke that covenant, you know? And the rest is history all the way up till now, man. But the Lord has always had a remnant who he was going to restore, man. So the people from the beginning are being hallowed, man. And hallowed means holy and separate, all right? And as brothers have been going into, here it is. Here it is, Revelation, real quick. Revelation, the 11th chapter, tells you, verse 2, when he measured the temple, Revelation 11 and 1, arise, and it was given unto me a reed like unto a rod, and the angel stood, saying, rise and measure the temple of God and the altar of them that worship therein. But the court which is without the temple, leave out and measure it not, for it is given unto the Gentiles. So here it is, they're cut out. The holy city shall be treaded underfoot 42 months. So the Gentiles are not a part of this thing, the natural heathen. You see, they're out. They're not measured within this number, which are sealed. Okay, they're not a part of this thing. Okay? The number of thy children whom thou longest for is fulfilled. Okay? And we know that's the 144, all right, in the large multitude. Beseech the power of the Lord, that thy people which have been called from the beginning may be hallowed. I, Ezra, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people whom I could not number. Now remember, you have the 144, which you can number that, but then you have the large multitude, which cannot be numbered. And I saw upon the Mount Zion a great people whom I could not number, and they all praised the Lord with songs. Now, what song are we going to be singing? Let's get that. Revelation 15 and 1. And I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, seven angels having the seven last plagues, for in them is filled the wrath of God. And I saw, as it were, a sea of glass mingled with fire, and them that had gotten the victory over the beast, over his image, and over his mark. See, this is what we have to tap into, because there's some of us who are going to get the victory over his beast, over his mark, his and everything else. So the what ifs don't matter. Right here it says there are some who are going to get that victory. That's that large multitude along with the 144, man. Over his mark and over the number of his name, stand on a sea of glass, meaning we're going to be on a chariot looking down, having the harps of God, and they sing the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are thy works, the Lord God Almighty, just and true are thy ways, thou King of the saints. Now, if we're singing the song of Moses, I make this point a lot, how the hell could that include all nations when Exodus 15 and 1, then Moses and the children of Israel, then sang Moses and the children of Israel a song unto the Lord and spake, saying, I will sing unto Yahweh, for he hath triumphed gloriously, the horse and his rider hath he thrown into the sea. And what does Revelation 6 and 9 say? There's a red horse and a rider on it had a great sword. So Esau, Edom, is now going to be the new Pharaoh, and that is going to be swallowed up. But he's going to be swallowed with the missiles, man. Okay? And his power structure is going to be taken, and we're going to come down and enslave them and the rest of the heathen, man. Now, in this song, Pharaoh's chariots, verse 4, what did it say, verse 3? The Lord is a man of war, Yahweh is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his hosts hath he cast into the sea. His chosen captains are drowned in the Red Sea. When you go down to verse 15, the dukes of Edom shall be amazed, the mighty men of Moab, all right, trembling shall take hold upon them, the inhabitants of Canaan shall melt away. The same nations that David boasted over having under his foot in his Psalms when he got his throne. So how in the hell, if we're singing the song of Moses, how in the hell does that equate to all nations being delivered? It doesn't make sense. So verse 42, 2nd Ezra 2 and 44, I, Ezra, saw upon a Mount Zion a great people whom I could not number, and they all praised the Lord with songs, and in the midst of them there was a young man of a higher stature, taller than all the rest, and upon every one of their heads he set crowns and was more exalted, which I marveled at greatly. So I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? All right, just like that in Revelation, the same question was asked unto John, what are these? All right, and he answered me and said, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing and have put on the immortal, and have confessed the name of God. Now are they crowned and receive palms. And I said unto the angel, what young person is this that crowneth them, giveth them palms in their hands? And he answered and said unto me, this is the Son of God. So this is the family reunion, man. Yahweh is going to be amongst us, whom they have confessed in the world. Then began I to greatly commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. Because when you stand stiffly for the true doctrine, for the true name of the Lord, you get a lot of opposition. Because you're telling these heathen, you're telling these people, you have no part in the kingdom of heaven. We're going to rule over you. That takes a bold man. Okay? So then I began to commend them which stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. All right? Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell my people what manner of things and how great wonders of the Lord thou God has seen. And now we're reporting it to you. But this is the remnant. This number which is sealed, this great people that were called from the beginning, that's the remnant. You see? The remnant will return unto the Lord, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, through the preaching of the word. So with that, you know, I'll go ahead and end it. Hopefully I will edify. Shalom.